under metal cutting, next topic is effective rake and relief angle. Under the first condition, see, this is the workpiece. This is the workpiece, this is the center line of workpiece. This is center line of workpiece. In most common cases, tool will be coinciding at the center line, at the center point of workpiece. But in some cases, due to some offset, for example, if the tool is coinciding here, then there will be some offset. For this case, we have to find effective relief and effective rake angle. For this type of condition. Okay. Sin theta is equal to opposite by hypotenuse. Opposite is offset. Hypotenuse is, this is radius. Okay. So theta is equal to sin inverse of offset by radius. Theta inverse offset angle is equal to sin inverse offset by radius. With this offset angle theta f, we have to find effective relief angle and effective rake angle. When the tool is above the center line of workpiece, we have to add this back rake angle and this theta f. Alpha b is back rake angle. This theta is end relief angle. For effective relief angle, when the tool is above the center line of workpiece, we have to subtract. So these two formula you have to remember. For rake angle, when the center line is above the workpiece, you have to add. But if it comes to relief angle, you have to subtract. This is the first condition. Second condition is, if the tool is below the center line of workpiece, we have to find this theta f by same formula and same condition. But when the tool is below the center line of workpiece, theta ee, that is effective end relief angle, we have to add with this theta f. It is vice versa, but the condition is varying here. Okay? When the tool is below the center line of workpiece, we have to add this offset with end relief angle. But for alpha BE, we have to subtract. I'll tell you how to remember this, okay? When the tool is above the center line of workpiece, we have to add rake angle with offset. If the rake angle is added with offset when the tool is above the workpiece, then end relief angle should be subtracted. It is understood, because we have only two angles here. Okay, when the tool is below the center line of workpiece, we have to add end relief angle. Relief angle with offset. I am not adding the subtraction portion here, because it is understood, because we have only two angles here, rake angle one and relief angle. If rake angle is added, then a relief angle should be subtracted. Altogether, this is formula number 10. This is final formula in metal cutting operation. For gate exam, you have to remember this tabular column. You have to remember this, and you have to remember this theta f. Theta f is equal to sin inverse offset by radius. This is very rarely asked for gate exam, but also you have to remember this. Okay. Thank you.